Lance Mechanics here today, and if you clicked on the thumbnail, that means you're interested in what's going on with your engine. I'm going to show you how to prevent it, but first you have to understand what's going on with your engine and what kind of engine you have. This is the problem with all modern vehicles, so we're going to get into it. First, you have to understand what you have. What you have in a modern vehicle is something called a direct injection engine. What's happening is they're injecting fuel directly into the cylinder using one of these. It's a high-pressure fuel injector. Think of it like a diesel. They came out, honestly, this was invented in 1916 in the auto area. Let's call it the plane industry. Sorry, it's early. It's nothing new. It's old technology, but it's been modernized. And what happens is, instead of injecting like older vehicles right here on the intakes, you're directing directly into the cylinder. So you're bypassing the intakes. And what's happening on modern vehicles, you're getting all this carbon buildup down in the cylinder on top of the valves. And this is causing a lot of drivability issues. And with the old style, this fuel coming in right here would clean all that and it wouldn't be an issue. There's some downsides to each system and there's some benefits to others. With GDI, you're getting improved fuel quality, better emissions, better cold start. There's a lot of benefits of this system. Some of the downsides are these drivability issues are extremely hard to diagnose. You're getting overfueling issues. You're having to do more oil changes and people aren't into maintenance these days. So what's causing the carbon issue? So with higher injection pressures and higher pressures in the cylinder head, what happens is you're getting blow by past the piston rings. That goes in the crankcase and then it comes up through wherever passages you have in the block. Those gases then come up through the top valve cover and they're going to go to a passage here or here. It just depends on your make and model. And then those are going to be fed into your intake. On this BMW, it happens to be on the turbo side. So it gets fed down here and all in here is just covered in oil and deposits. That gets fed right through here and then back into your intake, which ends up on your valve. So when this hot, misty oil hits the hot valve, it instantly carbonizes and builds up these deposits. This is so bad for an engine. As a mechanic, I had such a hard time diagnosing this. Every mechanic and every make and model is having a hard time diagnosing this. Many manufacturers have TSBs, ECM updates. It's not helping. There is one way you can prevent this, and let me explain. So if you made it this far in the video, I'm going to explain how to prevent this, and you're gonna say, well, why hasn't the OEM manufacturers done this? And the answer is not complexity. It's based on customers and what they've done in the past. So the one way to hugely mitigate this is with an oil catch can. You put it in on the intake from the PCV valve to wherever, from the valve cover to the PCV valve back to the intake, doesn't matter. You just put it in line somewhere. And as the engine's running, all that oil mist is gonna pass through one inlet on here and it's gonna drop down and get caught right here. It's kind of sad. The only reason the automotive industry hasn't done it is because customers can barely even do their oil changes these days. Imagine this gets filled up with oil and then it starts sucking oil. That's gonna cause more issues than if you didn't have it. So it becomes another maintenance item and manufacturers are trying to get away from maintenance items because the average person can barely do an oil change these days. And I've seen it as a mechanic, 15, 20,000 mile or kilometer oil changes. And the customer's like, oh, I didn't know I had to do that. So it's not complexity. It's based on trial and error and history of what customers have done. So I'm not doing this today, but I will show you in a future video how to install an oil catch can, and this will help prolong the life of your engine. It's such a simple mod. I think every car should have it, but it becomes another maintenance item. But it's not a huge maintenance item. This is something that I'd say if you're on the ball and you really love your car, just empty it once a month or every oil change. Let the person know, hey, I have an oil catch can. Can you service this too? And that will solve so many of your issues. Because carbon buildup deposits on intake valves is the hardest thing to diagnose as an automotive technician. It throws all kinds of wrenches into your troubleshooting tree because it's just something you can't, there are ways, but it's just something you can't easily get diagnosed quick. And if you install these, you will help us long term. You will save the life of your engine, because these GDI systems are extremely tough on an engine, and it's just a simple modification you can do at home. I suggest looking into other videos. Engineering Explained has some good videos, oil catch can installations. I will do it on my Jeep Gladiator eventually, but I just want to get this video out quick and show people. Do it. Save your engine. When a modern GDI engine is costing upwards of $30,000, a friggin' $100 modification is all you need. So I highly recommend this. And Lance Mechanics, if you're new to the channel and you like it, like, subscribe, share with your friends. Have a great day.